All right. Are you ready? Yeah. One person is ready. Let's see what happens. Okay, so good morning, everyone. And nice to see you again. The numbers are not going down. That's always a good sign there. So there are many people who are new, who are just starting for the second part. Yeah, okay. A few of you. Okay, great. Welcome. We're going to throw you in the deep end because we're just coming to the most advanced and deepest part of these perceptions. So you get straight into the most. So if you feel like you are kind of your head is spinning, you know why. So let's see what happens. But as always, we're going to start the day with doing some meditation together, and then we will come back to the suttas very shortly. So please get ready and find a nice, comfortable position for yourself, and then we'll get started. All right, so again, just always, when you sit down, always come back to the basics of meditation every single time, because the basics of meditation is always the most important part. Meditation is simple. Meditation is easy. It is not complicated. And one of the most important things to uncomplicate meditation is just to be very patient and just to allow things to happen. Rather than trying to make the mind peaceful, trying to make the mind have good qualities, trying to achieve insight or whatever. These things arise by themselves. And the idea in meditation is always to be like a passive observer. To be sitting back, not to identify with all the doing, but to identify with the observer. If you identify with the observer rather than the doer, then you can see the doing happening without getting too involved. Again, it's the idea of being a passenger on the train, looking out the window and just allowing the scenery to happen without trying to get involved in that scenery. You are the passenger, the observer on the train. Your idea, your purpose is to be patient and allow things to happen. And the strange thing about the mind is that if you allow it to be and you don't do anything with it, its natural inclination is actually to be peaceful. And again, one of the main challenges in meditation is to let go a little bit more. The idea of letting go of the world so you don't have to think about it, worry about the future, all of these things. And sometimes all you need to do is just to nudge the mind very gently in the right direction. We have been talking about all the various kinds of perception. The very powerful perception in this regard is the perception of death. In the face of death, this world doesn't really matter so much. In the face of death, and you don't know when it's going to happen, all of these things become quite irrelevant. So just know that death is always a possibility. It is always around the corner. Now is the right time to be ready. And in this way, see if you can incline the mind away from this world and towards the path of spirituality, making the mind peaceful and mindful in the process. One of the benefits of doing a little bit of simple death contemplation is that you understand how peaceful dying actually is. This beautiful thing when you let go of everything and you just rely on the good qualities within. And that letting go process is actually very delightful and very unburdening and very freeing for the mind. So never fear death. For a good person, death is always a positive experience. So enjoy this experience of letting go. Enjoy the experience of allowing the world to fade away. Don't wait till you actually die. Bring in this beautiful experience into your life right now. Make use of these beautiful tools that we have on the Buddhist path. And apart from letting go of the world, it is often also necessary to nudge the mind just a little bit towards brightness and happiness and positivity, because the positivity is what draws the mind towards meditation. Sometimes very simple perceptions to use, like the perceptions of the life that you have lived, the precepts you have kept, the kindness that you have done in the world. Simple things where you just appreciate the value that you have lived by in your life. And just that feeling of one's own life well lived can bring a sense of positivity and gladness to the mind. Sometimes just very gently remind yourself of that. Remind yourself that you're part of this wonderful community for people who live in a positive way. And you also are trying your best to do the right thing. And just the trying, just the intention to do what is right in the world is worthy of so much respect. So have an appreciation for yourself, an appreciation for your own good conduct, and allow yourself to be inspired by that. And if you can, make sure that you feel the delight of meditation, the delight of letting the burdens be, and just allowing the mind to rest, even if just for a short period of time. And then when you get the meditation right, you're able to let go. It's like you're re-energizing yourself, allowing the energy which dissipates during the day to return to the mind. It creates a powerful mind that then can be used for any purpose you wish afterwards, whether it's for worldly purposes or for spiritual purposes. So at the end of every meditation, I always recommend you to review a little bit. Always review the state you are in, review the benefits of meditation, but also review the path to peace, the perceptions that you use, and what it actually means to let go. So spend a few moments on this before you come out. Okay, everyone, let's have a short break and we'll come back in at 9:30 again.